it's a weird sort of dichotomy that Carnival makes a great deal of money, but the people who actually perform, as opposed to the people who come and watch, don't usually see much of it. I mean, the 4 years I did it, I didn't pay myself a penny. I only paid the band. I paid for everything and paid the band. Carnival turns over about £100 million, but very few people see any of that except the authorities. So though the authorities like to play the game that, oh, it costs us so much money, they actually make an incredible amount of money out of the licensing. They say they don't, but they do.
I mean, my husband was amazing. His vision. And another exciting thing about working with him too was that you never could understand what he was doing.
We're all aware that he's rooted in Caribbean tradition. And I think, like, well, speaking for myself, I just feel really kind of grateful and just inspired by what that Caribbean sound system tradition has brought to England as a whole, and what it's led to, and all of the offshoots and all of the different sort of journeys that sound system setup has gone on since, you know, the 70s and 80s when it was established in England, and when it's just grown from there.
If I was told that I couldn't go this year, I'd have a fit. Like, if my mum told me I couldn't go, you can't tell me I can't go. Like, if they shut it down, people would riot. Like, I think people would actually go crazy if they shut it down.
To me, it's ultimately positive. It gets everyone together and there's no barriers. That's the most positive thing. I don't know why that's not in the press. They tend to concentrate more on the crime, which statistically is not anything. I'm sure Glastonbury per square feet of humans is much worse. I don't know what's going on. The next day it's always criminal activity that's the story, not this multicultural, incredible thing that people have spent all year working on.
A day before Carnival. Listen, like, I can't even go to sleep. It's just like a happy moment. Yeah, I get to dance, I get to show what I've been working on for the whole year for Carnival, what I'm trying to show people, and then everyone's enjoying themselves. Like, you meet new people and a lot of things. You go on TV. I really want to be a dancer, so like, me going on TV helps my career and it helps the group, because they're going to know if I become famous one day, then I'm always going to be in this group, so they're going to know about this group as well. Yeah, I love it. Like, it's a day to express myself.
Being on the road during Carnival, playing this kind of music with everybody, just the vibe itself, it's just like, it's like an adrenaline rush. It's like you're on a high, like, oh my days, what's the next song? Oh my gosh, what are we going to dance to? It's just all exciting. It's just like a big rush, and then when it's over, it's like, you can't wait to do it again.
The biggest misconception is the press, actually. They seem to think that Carnival is all about crime and drugs, etc. And Carnival is nothing about those things. You know, there's no more crime and drugs in Carnival than there is in Glastonbury or in a big festival or on some football matches. We intend to do a commemoration, a minute silence in Carnival this year for the Grenfell people, where everybody pay their respects to the people from Grenfell, which is something that I am working on, and I want to have the bring Carnival to a standstill at 3 o'clock on the Monday afternoon.
Carnival is Carnival, because you see the colours in a Carnival that represent that Carnival should be like that. It's not about colour. It's about people coming together, yeah, and enjoying themselves and expressing themselves in whatever way they can.
I'm always proud to be Caribbean, but it's one of the times I'm most proud to be Caribbean. I feel like I'm almost, it's a home away from home in that sense, you know? I think there's a feeling of love around everybody. Everyone's enjoying what they're doing. Everybody's just enjoying the music and the vibes, and the vibe is love, isn't it? So everyone has that in them. So, you know, those single ladies out there and the single men out there, they're all on the same vibe. So, you know, twos are gonna match.
Being a bit skimpy or promiscuous, it's just a way of freeing up ourselves. If you don't like it, you don't have to wear it. But judging other people because they're a bit more skimpy than you, I think is totally wrong. It's an art form, and if you do your research, that art form comes in all different ranges.
If you go through Carnival itself, it's not only about the route, but when you come to the side streets, there are different groups from different nationalities having their own stage performances, which make the cultural part evaporating. It's splendid.